What's up everyone, today we're gonna be taking a look at this minor deck that I made recently. It's very spell bait deck, as you can see, with all the skeleton army, princess, minion horde and everything like that. It just baits our opponent's spells easily, and I hope you guys enjoyed the little clip that I put before the video started. It's from my friend that opened his super magical chest recently and me opening my legendary chest, so I hope you enjoyed that. And I've not really tested this deck out a lot, as you can see I only played one game with it. But without further ado, I think we're only going to be doing live battles today because I have no replays to show you guys, so let's get right into it. And I hope we don't really lose that many games because I want to be consistent in my uploads. So first off, we're going to be sending over a Goblin Barrel just to bait out his zap spell if he has one. So let's see how that does. Alright, so that worked out perfectly. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be sending our Skeleton Army with our Miner, and let's hope for the best. And as you can see, that actually worked out really, really well actually. So as you can see, that did about 1000 damage, which is not bad at all. And I'm going to be logging all that, because that's a really, really heavy push that's coming towards me. And he built up a big push from that, which is good for him. So yeah, oh my god, that his zap is so strong. So keep in mind his zap is level 12, I think, actually. Which is bad for us because his zap can one-shot our minion horde, which is not what we want. So right now we're going to be sending over our Goblin Barrel once again to bait out his spells. And we're going to send a princess on top of that, just to do some chip damage to his tower. And yeah, that worked out. I'm not going to say it worked out that well, but it did work, I guess. So here we're going to be using our Skeleton Army to distract all of that. So yeah, that worked out fairly well actually. So his Hawk is going to die off quickly over here, because the Skeleton Army is so strong. And guys, if you haven't already upgraded your Skeleton Army, go ahead, look at that. It's gonna take out that musketeer with no problem whatsoever. So we're gonna send our Miner and Goblin Barrel combination once again to just do damage to his tower. And he's gonna zap that away easily, which is not too big of a deal, but that can be a big problem later on. So he's gonna be doing that. I'm totally fine with that. And we're gonna take down his Mega Minion really easily. And we're gonna be sending over our Goblin Barrel, just so we can deal chip damage. And he's gonna be zapping away. Okay, maybe not really. But he's gonna be sending over a very big push very, very soon. If you guys can't really tell, look at that. He's gonna send his Hawk Rider. So we're gonna be doing that. And as you can see, his zap one-shots our minion horde, which is not good. But you can't really do anything, can you? So we're gonna send over this, and we're gonna send over that. And that musketeer is gonna lock onto a tower, which is not good at all. But as you can see, that those are gonna take down his tower, and he has to commit some elixir into defending. And our princess meanwhile is doing some chip damage to his tower there, which is good. And right now we're gonna be using our minion horde, and that's probably gonna bait out his zap spell. And we're gonna send over our Goblin Barrel, and he doesn't have the elixir to zap all of that because he just used his zap. So now I'm thinking he's gonna be sending his Hawk. So yeah, see, I guessed that. So over here his Hawk is gonna die really, really easily, and I'm gonna be sending over my log just to deal some chip damage to his tower. And I'm gonna do that and that and that and that, just like I can bait his spells. And he's not gonna be using his zap, which is smart of him, because now he can defend against whatever I need to throw at him. So as you can see, I'm gonna be using my Skeleton Army, and that's gonna work out fairly well against this Hawk Rider. And guys, you have to upgrade your Skeleton Army. It's just one of the best. It's one of the best troops in the game. I think they overbuffed it, honestly. And that was a fail on my part, but which is not good. So we're gonna send over all that because there's only 13 seconds left. And if we don't do something, it's gonna end up as a draw, which is not what we want. And come on, take his tower out. Come on, no, 68 health, that was so close. Wow, that was painful. Alright guys, we're gonna do another live battle, and I hope this time we do actually win. We were so close just now, but we didn't manage to peel off the W. So again, we're gonna be sending over our Goblin Barrel to bait his spells. And he's not gonna, okay, he's gonna be using a zap, which is good. And right now, we're gonna be sending over a surprise miner and Skeleton Army once again, like our last battle, just so we can cause some havoc. And he does have a lot, unfortunately. But he defended that quite well, to be honest. And as you can see, that's actually gonna do quite a lot of damage. But we're gonna be zapping that so it doesn't actually take our tower down. And right now, we're not looking that good because he's a level 11. But let's just hope for the best. So over here, we're gonna be sending over our Golden Barrel once again to bait out his zap. And he's gonna be using his lock to defend our Scanner Army. So looks like he's not gonna be using his zap after all. So what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be sending over our miner. But he did fairly well over there. So I gotta give him credits for that. He defended my push fairly well. So over here, we're not doing that good. I guess we're doing good, but we're not doing as good as I anticipated to do. So I'm gonna use a Goblin Barrel now just because he just used his zap. And he's gonna use his lock, I think. Okay, not really. He's not gonna use his lock. He's gonna suffer a good amount of damage, I'd say. So over here, our princess is doing some chip damage over to his tower, and he's gonna be doing that. I'm totally fine with that, and I'm gonna be sending our miner just so we can deal some chip damage to his tower, and he's gonna be using a skeleton army to defend my stuff, which is smart. But now our Minion Horde is gonna sneak in and do a lot of damage, so that's good. And now we're gonna using our princess. We're gonna be using our princess to defend his troops over there. I'm gonna be using an ice spirit and a skeleton army. Actually, we don't need to use a skeleton army. I'm just gonna send over our Goblin Barrel to deal chip damage. And he's gonna be not doing anything. Okay, he's gonna be using his zap. So after he used his zap and his lock, this is our golden opportunity, guys. We have to do this. So I'm gonna be sending a log over because I want to deal some damage to this tower. And come on, Skeleton Army, you can do this. Okay, so he defended that quite well. I gotta give him credits for that. And we're gonna be doing that and that, just so you don't die to his push over here. And right now, he's doing a lot of damage to us, but thankfully, his tower is just one princess shot away from dying. So we're gonna do that, and now we're gonna defend our tower. So let's see what he does. I don't think he's gonna even try anymore, because I'm just gonna be spamming troops over and hope he doesn't defend. And there we go, we won a game, finally. I've been losing life battles. I have no idea why, but I tend to lose life battles always, which makes me think Clash Royale, the battles are actually rigged. That's what I've been thinking. But let's get into another battle. And yeah. So we're facing against 2B over here. Sorry if I pronounced his name wrongly. But once again, Goblin Barrel on his tower. And guys, if you haven't tried his deck out yet, be sure to do so. It's so fun. Because I've been playing against Giant Poison for so long, and it's just been very boring actually, because it's so repetitive. You keep facing Giant Poison, and this guy's gonna be using a... So, wait a second. I'm sorry for the awkward moment of silence over there. But we're gonna send over our miner to take down his pump. And for you people that don't really know, the pump costs about 6 elixir now. So that's a huge nerf to the pump, and I've been seeing very little pump usage recently, because it's just not good anymore, I think. Even though it does give you an extra elixir, but I don't think it's worth it anymore, because if people rocket it, it's gonna be a fair elixir trade, which is not good. So over here, we're gonna be sending over our Goblin Barrel and our Ice Spirit, and that did quite a lot of damage to him. And right now, he's gonna be doing that. I'm gonna zap all that did, and I'm gonna send over my Skeleton Army together with my Miner, and let's see what that does. So he's gonna be doing that. I'm totally fine with that. So yeah, that didn't actually do as well as I anticipated, but it's alright. We're gonna be doing that, and that's gonna work out fairly well for us. And we're gonna be logging all that did. And yeah, he's gonna throw us a well plate. I'm just gonna throw him a thanks. because he's good. I don't know actually. So right now, I'm gonna be using the Ice Blade to soak up all the damage over there, and the Skeleton Army defend against this. And that worked out fairly well. And as you can see, his right tower is all the way down to 1265, and the Skeleton Army is just going ham. Holy cow! Look, guys, I swear, the Skeleton Army is so good. You guys need to upgrade it. As you can see, it's just gonna wreck everything over here. And wow, that worked out fairly well actually. So it's gonna be doing that. I'm totally fine with that. Log all of that dead. And that was perfect. So we're gonna be doing a split push over here to bait out some of his spells. And he's going to be doing that. I'm totally fine with that. So now we're looking very, very good actually. And I believe he's gonna be sending over his Royal Giant soon. So I'm gonna zap all that dead really quickly. And right now, yeah, this is basically good game. I'm gonna try my good game. And yeah, GG. So guys, I hope you enjoyed the episode. And if you guys don't have the miner yet, be sure to buy it. It's gonna be the new meta in the game right now, because I've not been seeing any giant poison lately. I'm gonna show you my log real quick. All I've been seeing is just giant, normal giant decks, like giant Sparky, which is not what you see often. And what else? Giants. Nothing really, actually. So yeah, there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you like this deck, be sure to give it a big thumbs up down below. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. And peace.